Good morning,
Colonel Bai.
It's Friday, February 22nd.
It's a day 4.
I'm Terry.
And I'm Kat.
And here are your morning announcements.
The Delft 2019 spring semester has officially started. Student registration is now open and will remain open until March 8th, 2019. Interested students who are taking a grade 12 French class and who did not take the Delft in the fall can register anytime at the OCDSB website. Ask Madame Byers if you have any further questions.
Are you seeking help for any courses you're taking? Tutoring Club will be held on day 1s during lunch in room 136.
This year's musical will take place on February 27th, 28th, and March 1st. Be sure to get your tickets.
Course selection is due today. Signed Career Cruising printouts are to be handed in to geography teachers for grade 9s, history teachers for grade 10s, English teachers for Ontario grade 11s, and TOK teachers for IB grade 11s. Please see or email guidance if you have any questions or issues with the course selection process.
The University of Toronto's Faculty of Arts and Science will be presenting an applicant advising session today in room 215 at lunch. All students in grade 11 and 12 who are interested in learning more are invited.
Guitar Club is open to all on Wednesdays in room 159. Be sure to check it out if you have any interest in guitar playing.
Do you like listening to great live music? If so, be sure to check out the Coffee House, which will be happening on Thursday, March 7th.
Black History Month Club will be hosting a guest speaker today in the library at lunch. Alden Holder is coming to talk about his youth summit, called Smart Start, as well as his upcoming documentary. There will be a lot of information on opportunities to build your leadership skills. Let's take a look at some of the things he's done in the past.
There's not enough safe spaces for us as people of color, as people to be able to come and just talk about the hardships, the challenges that we go through.
The narrative of blackness that was kind of being imposed on me kept me away from trying to find even more of my community because I thought I would have to sacrifice like my art and my budding queerness at the time.
There are many people that come into our communities and then they're advocating for us. You need this, you need that. We know that you need this, we're here for you. But I think it's hard when we grow up. So now I'm here. Now I can tell you what I need.
There's more people of color than there's ever been since I was born. I've been around. People of color, there were few of us. Now there's a multitude of us, but we're not in the important places.
Afro-Canadians are always entrepreneurs. We have to figure stuff out to just survive, you know?
Why is so much money invested in making sure that the world, particularly young black men, think that they're inferior? Because they know they're not.
What is it to have agency in your own lands? What is it to control your resources? What is it to sing your songs, have your drums, know your regalia, know your stories?
If we, as black people, were to adopt entrepreneurship and entrepreneurship, we'd be unstoppable.
My family goes back to the Black Loyalists. My dad was in the number 2, you know, construction, the Black Battalion, right? So all of us have these stories.
This notion that the world is really messed up, but I'm perfect so I can change the world. But rather, how can I change this world?
I want a global community that can live just, fair, equitable lives that are meaningful.
You know, they say Black History is Black History Month, but to me, Black History is Canadian history.
I am a new brand of breath, a wind that nips at your ankles and sings.
So the challenge is also the opportunity. It's about building bridges between communities that are seen as a community, but recognized within house that we're actually a multiplicity of communities.
Let the answer fall from the sky, or be the sky.
Black or white.
That's all from us today, CB. Have a phenomenal Friday.